Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hello everyone, hope you are all fine. This from CTY International School, Ring Road, Ibadan, Oyo State, Nigeria. My name is Mrs. Jimo. I'm taking you mathematics. The topic for today is reading clocks to quarter to. Let's say it everyone. Reading clocks to quarter to. We've learned reading clocks to the hour and reading clocks to the half hour in the previous classes. But today, we are learning reading clocks to quarter to. The first example says, what time is it? Look at the wall clock on the screen. The wall clock has two ends, the short end and the long end. Don't forget that you were told in the previous classes that the short end is also known as a end, while the long end is also known as minute end. Now, how do we read clock to quarter to? If long hand is on 9 and short hand is on another figure, we are going to read the figure in which the short hand is pointing to. Look at this wall clock now. The long hand is pointing to 9, while the short hand is pointing to 2. That means we read this clock by saying quarter to 2. Quarter to 2. Long hand is on 9 and short hand is on 2. We say it's quarter to 2. Look at the second example. The second example says, what time is it? That's the question. What time is it? Look at this wall clock. The long hand is also pointing to 9, while the short hand is pointing to 4. Don't forget that I told you when we were attempting number 1 that if long hand, which is also known as minute hand, is on 9 and the short hand is on a figure or pointing to a figure, you are going to read the figure in which that short hand is pointing to. If you look at this wall clock carefully, you will see that the long hand is pointing to 9, while the short hand is pointing to 4. So we read this clock by saying it's quarter to 4. It's quarter to 4. Let's go to the third example. In the third example, we are asked, what time is it? Look at the wall clock. The long hand is pointing to 9, while the short hand is pointing to 6. So we say it's quarter to 6. It's quarter to 6. If you look at the examples from number 1 to number 3, you will see the long hand in number 1 is pointing to 9. Long hand in number 1 is pointing to 9. The same thing applicable to the long hand we have in number 2. Look at this clock. The long hand is pointing to 9. The last one also, long hand is pointing to 9. So all you need to do is to put it at the back of your mind that whenever long hand is pointing to 9 and short hand is pointing to another figure or a figure, you will read the figure in which short hand is pointing to. That's why in number three, we say it's quarter to 6. In number 2, look at number 2, we say it's quarter to 4. And in number 1, we say it's quarter to 2. This is the end of the class. Bye.